morning, students. So as we were reading, form a frog in a well. A frog in a well, which is written by Alice Schutter. Alice Schutter, who is a famous American writer. Okay. So in this poem, there is a frog who lives in a well. A frog who doesn't want anything what is happening around the world. What is new things around the world? He doesn't know beyond of the world. He doesn't know beyond of that environment in which presently he is living. So in this poem, a frog in a well is referred as a person who makes feel contentment with environment in which he is living. He has adapted that environment. He doesn't want to do any extra efforts. So in this poem, poet compare a frog just like as a bad human who doesn't do any extra efforts to improve his knowledge, to improve his skill. Okay? So if a person want to develop his skills, his knowledge, then he has to do extra efforts. He has to do new things every day, because there is no limitation of knowledge and skills. Okay, students. So today we will do question number A, which is based on understanding the poem. So what we have to do, we have to complete these sentences which is given. Okay, that sentence is from your poem which we have already read. Okay, so let's start. The word is dash dash and dash. The word is dash dash and dash. To according to a frog. So according to frog, how is the world? According to frog who is living in a well, okay, जो well में रह रहा है, according to frog who is living in a well, how is the world? The world is round, deep and cool. So as you can see in your book on first stanza, so the world is round and deep and cool. So according to the frog, how is the world in which he is living? जिस world में वो रह रहा है, जिस environment में वो रह रहा है, उसके according to world कैसे है? So according to the frog, the world is round, deep and cool. Okay, now next, the bottom of the world is a pool. Okay, according to the frog, the bottom of the world is pool. Frog ke according, jo bottom hai world ka, wo kya hai? This is a pool. Okay, here is mentioned in first stanza also, as you can see in your book, first stanza, the bottom of the world is a pool with just enough room for a frog alone. Okay, now next. The walls of the world are made of. In which world he is living? The world are made of stone. So according to frog, the world are made of stone. Made of stone. World जो है वो किसकी बनी है? Stone की बनी है. So as you can see in second stanza, the walls of the world are of stone on stone. जो world का जो wall है, ओके वर्ल्ड का जो वॉल है वो किसका बना है, स्टोन का बना है. बिकॉज इफ यू हैव सीन वेल देन, अगर आपने कुआं देखा हो, वेल देखा हो, सो वेल इज मेड अप ऑफ स्टोन ऑन स्टोन, स्टोन ही स्टोन की बनी हुई थी. एंड वेल इज अ वर्ल्ड, वेल इज अ वर्ल्ड ऑफ फ्रॉग, फ्रॉग का वो वर्ल्ड है. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट, द स्काई इज डैश एंड डैश, हाउ इज दिस अकॉर्डिंग टू द फ्रॉग, हाउ इज द स्काई. सो लुक इन द लास्ट लाइन, आई कैन सी अ स्टार इन अ लिटिल राउंड स्काई. अकॉर्डिंग टू फ्रॉग, व्हेन ही लुक्स अप हाई देन द स्काई लुक्स लिटिल एंड राउंड, द स्काई लुक्स लिटिल एंड राउंड. सो द स्काई इज लिटिल एंड राउंड. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो यू विल डू इट इन योर नोटबुक. नाउ वी विल डू क्वेश्चन आंसर. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी विल डू सेक्शन बी, आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस. First question is, who is the speaker? How do you know? In this poem, who is the speaker? Speaker who is telling story or poem, that is called a speaker. So in this poem, who is the speaker? A frog is the speaker. A frog is the speaker. Second question is, how do you know? How do you know a frog is a speaker? Because I is being used in the poem and this poem is based on frog. I is being used. As you can see, last line, I can see a star in a little round sky. Okay, in second stanza, last line, I can see a star in a little round sky. So I is being used here. I is being used in the poem and this poem is based on frog. So as we know, here the speaker is a frog. Now next, where is the speaker? Where is the speaker? Speaker, it means frog. Where is the frog? Okay. Where is the speaker? Which lines in the poem tell you? Speaker, it means frog. Where is the frog? Where is living? A frog is living in a well. Okay, so the speaker is in the well. Which lines tell you that frog is living in a well? The lines that world is round, deep and cool. The bottom of the world is a pool tells us that the speaker is in the world. Well, the speaker is in the well. Okay? So, here in the poem, there are two lines which tells us the speaker is in the well. जो हमें ये बताते हैं कि स्पीकर जो है वो कहाँ है वेल में. द फर्स्ट लाइन इज द लाइन द वर्ल्ड इज राउंड डीप एंड पूल एंड द सेकेंड लाइन द बॉटम ऑफ वर्ल्ड इज अ पूल दैट टेल अस द स्पीकर इज इन द वेल. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड, व्हाट डज द स्पीकर थिंक अबाउट द वर्ल्ड. फ्रॉग, हियर इज अ फ्रॉग. व्हाट ही थिंक्स अबाउट द वर्ल्ड and why he thinks that so, why. Okay, so the speaker thinks about the world that is deep, round and cool because the speaker is in the well. Okay, so the speaker thinks because here frog thinks the world is round, deep and cool. Why? Because why he thinks the world is round, deep and cool? Because frog is in the well. क्योंकि वो well में है and the well is round, deep and cool. So he thinks that. Okay? So the speaker thinks about the ball that is deep, round and cool because the speaker is in the web. Once again, a frog is the speaker because eye is being used in the poem and this poem is based on frog. Now next, where is the speaker? Which lies in the poem? Tell you that. Okay. The speaker is in the well. In this poem, there are two lines which tell us the speaker is in the well. The first one is the line, the world is round, deep and cool. And the second one is the bottom of the world is a pool. That two lines tell us the speaker is in the well. Now, third. What does the speaker think about the world? Five. The speaker thinks about the world that is deep, round and cool. Why? Because the speaker is in the well. Okay. So that was your question answer, which you have to do also in your notebook and you have to learn also. Goodbye. Have a nice day.